Sociologists and sports psychologists suspect that it will actually to make it to professional level of sport where the earlier participants, and that is, their birth date is earlier in the sport year, as you. So in youth baseball leagues, the sport year typically begins at August the 1st, so children born in August are the earlier participants. In a random sample of 250 Major League Baseball players born since 1975, 35 were born in the month of August. National demographic statistics show that 9% of those were born in August. Is there a higher percentage of professional baseball players born in August than in the general population? We want to use a 95% confidence interval to help us answer the question. So, since we're doing a confidence interval, this is going to be a pilot problem. So we're going to start off with our P. The parameter that we're interested in is the random sample of 250 people. So our P cap is going to be 35 out of 250. So I'm over here in my calculator. I'm going to do that. So 35 out of 250 is 14%. We're looking at a p-hat of 14%. Next up, we need to test our assumptions. So our assumptions for confidence interval, there's two of them. First, we must assume that it is random. So it is given. Data runs from a random sample. Secondly, we need to determine the 10% condition. Right, so we need to say, we need to check the 10% condition. So we have to say we must assume, or it is safe to assume, I don't know if that's a safe assumption. I mean, if you think about that, how many baseball teams are there? There's 30 baseball teams or something like that. And then probably what, 25, 30 guys, maybe 900 a year. I think that's probably a pretty safe assumption. Forget my ignorance of baseball. But I just simply don't know those numbers, but I do think it's safe to assume. The third condition is normality. So we have to test to see whether it works. So m times p hat. So in other words, we have 250 times 14, which is going to equal 250 times 14. 36. This is going to be 215. Since both of these, both, are greater than or equal to 10, we can safely assume. Next up, we're going to run the test. This is a random sample. Zero. Proportion. And then actually perform the other. So the formula that we use is two hand. That's your minus. C star. Root of the p hat is Are you using a 95%? Are you over 95% confidence interval? So you should remember that that's 1.96 on the Z-value. If you don't remember that, you can always go to your booklet and you go to 95%. So here's our 95% confidence interval. So we're going to be 1.96. So we're in front of the examples. So 1.96 times the square root of 0.94 over 250. Now, I'm not actually going to use the calculator or the calculator to figure those out. So instead, I'm going to go and use my test. So if I go to my stat menu, go to the test, I have to go down a little bit. We're not looking for a Z error, we're looking for a 1 proportion Z error. So it's right away. X is the number of successes, so we have 35 over 100 in the harvest. N is the number in our sample, 250. Confidence level, 95% in this case, calculate. And then there is this number. So, in this case, our confidence interval, 0.0972.183. So, our conclusion then would be, Now, the problem with the bill stated that the national average was 9%. So either way, even if the national average is 9%, with our confidence interval, we're saying that more than the national average of baseball players are born in August. 9.7 is the bare minimum for our confidence interval. So this then would be evidence to support that more baseball players, the question is there a higher percentage of professional baseball players born in August than during the population? Yes, absolutely there is, because our interval is 9.7, the national average is 9. So hopefully that helps you answer how to figure out how to answer one of these types of questions. Come back next time for how to do a one proportion Z test.